a big thank you to you for inviting me, because as a GP, I'm aware that whilst I can sometimes be a solution to much of the problems in A&E, and that sometimes also we can cause some of the problems at A&E. So I want to see, can I give you some ideas of how we might have hopefully worked together? This collaborative very much has came out of an idea from our new medical director, I'm looking around the room now, Vin, who made an inspired change a few months ago. When I was working with some A&E consultants on how do we sort out the A&E issues, it was very much short term, the next 2 months, the next 3 months. But then Vin came in and said, Tom, let's accept that we can't sort it out in a few months. What we might be able to do is sort it out over a few years. And I will work with my colleagues at NHS England to give you and colleagues the headroom, you in the room today, to try and develop systems which will make this change. So I'm very, very pleased to be with you this morning. What I want to now talk about is how general practice can perhaps be designed to improve the patient flows through the hospital. What I'm going to talk about now is happening in some parts of London or the UK, but not every part of London and the UK. And these are ideas whereby if we just had a few of these things, perhaps the systems might work better for our patients and better for the A&E departments. We've just moved now to general practice 8-8. I don't think most patients realise that, but in London we have an 8-8 GP service. We need to make sure that is comprehensive, consistent, and well advertised, so patients know any time between 8 and 8 you can see someone. But patients are aware, if I've got an urgent problem, I can go to A&E and I will be seen probably within 4 hours. You don't think about that in general practice. That's what we should do. That all patients who've got an urgent problem, it should be very clear and you should be seen in general practice within 4 hours. And the patients will make the right choice. Rapid home visiting. Too many patients are worried. They call for a visit. Is it an hour? Is it 4 hours? Is it 12 hours? They're feeling scared and vulnerable. So the natural choice for them is to call an ambulance. If we had a system whereby patients called for a home visit, they could perhaps be seen within an hour. That might give confidence to those patients and reduce patients coming to A&E. Nursing homes. Nursing homes get a varied response from general practice. Some areas have got a fantastic link system where patients are seen within 2 hours when they call a GP. We could do that throughout London. So that nursing homes, will stop being the default provider of patients to A&E. London Ambulance Service will go to a patient at home. They know they don't really need to take that patient to A&E, but they feel they can't get a doctor out to that patient and they've got no other choice. In some parts of London, in our area, we've got a system where all GPs, they've got a contract to respond to ambulances at the patient's home when called, and that's within 2 hours. But also, we do need the staff. And that's where either Homes for Londoners, so they can help to make sure we recruit the staff that we need. 111. Now I'm going to say this as we'd like this to happen, but in fact, most of this is happening, but not throughout the country. When you call an ambulance, it's called 911, it's a clinical triage. Whereas a direct link, the nurse's home can call via 111 to get a GP assistance. As a dental service, rather than going to A&E for dental pain. But also what we don't have is where 111 can directly book into general practice. So patients know if 111 says you need to be seen within a GP, perhaps within 4 hours, 111 can book into that GP. That does happen in parts of London, but not all London. Out of hours. The out of hours service can be a bit varied. We want to make sure that health visiting service is rapid. That coordinate for my care is used by all out-of-hours providers. Urgent care centres follow the London quality standards in the out-of-hours system, so that patients know, if I go to that urgent care centre, I know I will get the chance to have an x-ray. Many patients go to A&E because they think that's the only way they can get an x-ray. But what we want to see, can we develop a system whereby we've got a consistent offering in our urgent care centres and out of our providers have access to my GP records. Emergency departments, if only they work better with general practice. Some places can redirect a patient attending directly back to their GP and book an appointment. So at 2 in the afternoon, it's a primary care problem, you can ring Dr. Coffey's practice and you can see me that day. Homilton Hospital has got a fantastic system whereby they recognise their repeat attenders. And they've got dedicated workers. These patients often have comorbidities of drug and alcohol, mental health issues. If you have a dedicated system of these patients, you can reduce their attendances and work with general practice. And the GPs also can be based to work within general practice, not just seeing the urgent patients, but the frail patients, and making sure we've got co-located out of hours. The wards often worry about discharging patients. You know, is it safe to discharge the patient? Will the GP see that patient? In some areas, the wards ring up the GP the day before and arrange the GP to visit on the day of discharge. What we do locally is a clear NHS NICE requirement. Any child with asthma who attends an A&E or is admitted needs to see a GP within 48 hours of discharge. In some areas, those wards and A&E departments are able to book that GP appointment before they leave their department and not leave it to chance. And wards should be able to arrange a GP follow-up. All these interventions, all these solutions exist somewhere in London. My belief is that we could have a system where these systems exist throughout London, where patients understand there is a clear offering of what general practice can do for patients when they require urgent assistance. My ambition, as one of the urgent care needs for London, is to try and develop these systems throughout London and work with you who are on the front line to make sure we can improve the system for London. Thank you very much.